Hello, welcome to the video number 5 of the series Exploring ROS with a two-wheeled robot. My name is Marco Arruda, and at the end of this video, you are going to be able to use the algorithm to perform obstacle avoidance using the robot of this series. So, in order to do that, we are going to use the RDS. If you don't have an account yet, you can create one for free, just following the link in the description of this video and clicking this button right here, sign up. After having your account, you're going to be able to see this screen here. So you must see this public list project. But in order to keep going with our project, I'm going to create a private project here. So let's do it. Create new project. And I'm going to call it part 5, obstacle avoidance. I'm going to put the same for the description. Create project, and it's done. So let's open it. Wait a few seconds until the ROS environment is ready, and there it is. So let's start cloning the repositories we have for the project. So let's open here a new terminal. First of all, we need the robot description and the simulations. So let's get into the simulation workspace source folder. And it's empty, as you can see. So for this project, until now, we have worked in a single repository, the simulation repository, and we have created 4 commits, one for each video. And for this part number 5, we have here a new word, which was committed in this 5th commit. Okay, so word number 2, which is basically the word number 1 we have been using with some obstacles. Okay, so let's clone it. Let's go to the overview page. Just copy here, get back to the workspace. Git clone. Enter. Okay, there it is. Let's compile it. Just make sure we have everything ready to be used. And in the meantime, let's open another terminal. Let's get into the catkin workspace, source folder, and I'm gonna clone the second repository we have created. And actually, this repository was created after the video number 4 for the reading laser task. Okay, and we have here another commit, which is the obstacle avoidance script that the one was created for this video. That's the file we are gonna use during this tutorial, okay? Which is basically a single script in Python to perform the obstacle avoidance task using the robot. So let's get to the overview page here, copy the address, get back to the catkin folder, and clone right here. So git clone, name the address of the repository, and compile the workspace. So now let's start the simulation. Just clicking right here, select launch file, and from our simulation workspace, my worlds, world launch, okay. And this launch file now, after the last commit, it's pointing to the new world file, which is world number, world 2, okay. So the launch file now is using this new argument, world, world 2, okay. So let's wait a few seconds until we have it ready. Okay, here it is. And we have some obstacles in the same world we had before. So let's open the IDE and take a look in our obstacle avoidance algorithm. Let's put it bigger. Okay, so here inside the catkin workspace, we have two-wheeled robot, motion planning. Inside the scripts folder, we have the reading laser, which is the same code we have created in the previous video. And now we have this obstacle avoidance. I prefer to keep the file already done here, and I can explain line by line instead of creating it from the scratch. Okay, so basically I started from the reading laser file. But now we are using we are importing this new message twist because we want to publish some messages to the robot in order to move it. Okay, and instead of just putting the mean of the values from the laser inside this array, now I'm creating a dictionary so I can remember and I can use the regions by this alias I have created here. Okay, so the first points are comes from the right side of the robot, the next ones from the front right of the robot, and then front of the robot, front left, and left side of the robot. Okay, and then after each message we receive, we are taking an action according to the message. Okay, so let's take a look in what we have, what we are considering for the robot. So let's take a look in that image right here. So in this example for the obstacle avoidance task, we are going to use only the front right and front left regions of the laser. Okay, so we have basically 8 cases here. The first one, we have no obstacles in these 3 regions of the robot, and then we have obstacle only in the front region of the robot, and then the front right, front left, and then now we are matching front with front right, front left, and the 3 regions, and finally front left and front right of the robot. Okay, so I have implemented here each case we have. So I'm calling here case 1, we have no obstacles, and case 2, case 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. What is the most important here is that I am considering an obstacle only if it is at least 1 meter from the robot. So if the obstacle is far more than 1 meter from the robot, I'm not considering an obstacle. Okay, that's why we have here this number 1 a lot of times. Actually it's a good practice to create an argument, and you must be able to set this argument in a launch file. It's gonna make it easier if you want to change the parameter. Okay, so basically after selecting the case we want to use, so according to the readings of the laser, we are setting here the linear x velocity of the robot and the angular z velocity, which means that if the robot must go straight or turn to the left or right side. Okay, so angular z means that the robot's is gonna rotate around the z axis, and let's spawn the robot and take a look in the z axis. So ROS launch, my two-legged robot, spawn. Okay, and we have here in this scene, I don't want to spawn the robot at the center of the world because we have some obstacles here, so it's not gonna work like this. Let's put the robot more or less right here, which is, let's count here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 squares, so 8 meters, and that's the y-axis. So let's set here the argument y equals to h, and we must see the robot more or less in this position. Okay, great, there is the robot. So basically we have some cases here of movement, and we have the robot there. So now we can suppose that the robot has no obstacles in front of it, or front right, front left sides. Okay, and here we have the z-axis. So let's take a look in the transformation, in the reference of the robot. We have the z-axis, this blue axis here. Okay, so if we have, for example, an obstacle in front of the robot, we have to choose. Okay, so we can go to the left or to the right because we don't have obstacles in the left or the right side of the robot. So here I'm choosing to go to the left side. Why the left? Because this is a positive number. And we have the z-axis here, which means positive rotation would be in this direction here, like this, okay? So left side. And the same if we have an obstacle in the right side of the robot. So let's suppose we have something on this side of the road, we have to go to the left side. So I'm using again positive value. If we have something in the left side of the robot, let's go to the right side. That's why we have a negative value here. Okay, and you can see that the other cases are almost the same thing, but we have to consider all of them. And finally, I'm considering here that we can reach an impossible point. Actually, it's not gonna happen. But if you forget to set something here, or maybe if we type something wrong here, we should get into this case, which is a known case. Okay. Finally, I'm printing the state description, which is the case number here, or the unknown case. And finally, setting to this object message, which is twist message, the values of the linear x and angular z. Okay, and finally, publishing the message to the top key command velocity. Well, in the main function, we are using this publish variable. I'm considering it's a global variable because I want to use inside the take action method, and I'm declaring it here at the beginning of the script outside of the function, so as none, because this must be known inside two different functions. That's why I have to use here global, because if I don't do like this, I am just creating a new variable inside this scope here. Okay. So basically that's it. That's the code. And now let's take a look how the robot behaves using this algorithm. So let's put the camera here in a good position, and let's run our motion planning package. We have the obstacle avoidance script. Let's start it. And we are starting with the nothing case, which means the robot cannot see any obstacles in any regions. Okay, so finally the robot reach here some point where there are some obstacles in the front of the robot and then left of the robot, and you can see the cases are varying very fast. So if you want to see it slowly, you can just set here, you can decrease the velocity, the speeds of the robot. Okay, and as you can see, the robot can avoid the obstacles following the rules and according to the cases we have created here. So let's play for a while. So I don't know, let's put some obstacles here. And as you can see, sometimes the algorithm can be broken. Why? Actually, it's not because we're not considering the cases, but because there are some gaps here. As you can see, there are some spaces between these two obstacles. So the robot may think that there are some space to go through, but actually there's not, because, right, then the robot detects something. Okay, so of course we are going to work with it, we are going to improve it in the next video. So for instance, I'm just going to put the robot in a different place, and we can keep going studying this algorithm. Okay, so let's put some obstacle here just to see how it behaves. Something to the right side, and the robot must go to the left side and avoid the obstacles. Okay, so basically that's it. This is how you can manage the obstacles. This is how we can work with the laser regions. So we are considering the regions of the laser again. Let's take a look at the image, and you should it's a good practice to create the cases. And now we are working more or less like a state machine, which makes the task a lot easier. Okay, so I hope this video can help you. And if you like this kind of video, and if you want to keep following this series, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell to be notified about the videos we publish every day. Thank you.